Ah, another busy summer day. You decide to wander down to Muscle Beach to work out. Your eyes oogling babes. Lost in your work, you nearly miss the Hollywood limousine that pulls in behind you. As the limo stops, a beautiful blonde emerges from the sunroof to announce,
"My name is Shallow, and I'm looking for one very good man."
"Out of the way, Bob.
Let me at her."
"Move it."
"To appear on the new TV show, Stallions." "Well, I guess you'll have to do. What's your name?"
"My name is Larry. Larry Laffer."
"Oh, hell. Good enough for who it's for."
After a few glorious moments in the back of the limo, in which you act out your favorite scene from No Way Out while Shallow acts out her favorite scene from Ice Station Zebra, you arrive at the studio and are escorted directly to the set where an episode of Stallions is being taped.
"And don't worry about thinking up answers while we're taping. We took the answers you gave us earlier and had our writers heat them up a little bit to make them acceptable to our sophisticated viewers. So when it's your turn to answer, just read your cue cards and you'll be just fine."
But wait, Miss Shallow. I didn't give you any answers earlier. I haven't gone out with these women. In fact, I've never even seen them before."
"Oh, don't worry, Lasser. Stallion number two is gonna lose anyway."
"No."
"Places, people, places. Lights. Playback. In 5, 4, 3.
Live from somewhere near Hollywood, California, it's the latest and greatest in embarrassment television. Stallions! Today, featuring three hot young fillies from the Mensa chapter of downtown Pasadena. And also featuring two of the hungest stallions we could pry away from Venice Beach. And now, let's all give a big whinny for the star of our show, Biff Stiff!
Welcome back, everybody. Let's meet our contestants. Stallion number two is a professional bodybuilder and part-time out-of-work concrete form dismantler who credits his physical success to Herbivite. Let's hear it for Larry Laffer. Stallion number one is also a professional bodybuilder and an apprentice condom sizer who guarantees that around him, women come first. Really slam them together for Rock Hard. As you regular fans know, both of these stallions recently had a dream date with each of our three lovely fillies. Cocktails at sunset, a romantic dinner under the stars, dancing by moonlight, followed by a trip back to the stall for a little heavy breeding. Oops, I'm sorry. I meant heavy breathing. And now, let's meet our three little fillies. Philly number one is a nuclear chemist specializing in zero-gravity liquid-fueled propulsion systems who has a mainframe computer right in her very own home. Yes, that's right. She really is a rocket scientist. How about some animal noises for Dr. Charlemagne? Philly number two also hails from Pasadena, where she leads a think tank specializing in international economics, monetary systems, and currency stabilization. Get it off for Dr. Sharla O'Hara. And finally, Philly number three is one hunk of prime horseflesh. With PhDs in marine biology, subatomic nuclear physics, and film studies, a woman who expects more from her man than just intelligent conversation, hoot it up for a while for Dr. Sharla Tan. I'm sure you all know the rules, so let's get right to the game. Larry, you're first.
Me? I don't know. I'm not really prepared. What the hell? I'll take Greek mythology for $500, Alex.
That's about all of this we need to see, isn't it? Let's fast forward.
And we're back with our contestants. Larry, what now?
Could I buy a vowel, Pat?
Yikes, this is not going well. Let's cut to the chase.
And the winner of today's show, Rock Hard! Rock and Sharla win an all-expense-paid cruise down the lovely Mexican Riviera with stops at Tijuana and Juarez. And our second prize goes to Larry Laffer. Immediately after the show, you'll travel by studio limo to the exclusive health spa and resort La Costa Lata, where you'll spend a wonderful two, some expenses paid, weeks. Thanks for watching, folks, and be sure to tune in again tomorrow for another episode of... Stallions!
Rock, honey, here's your tickets for the cruise. I'm afraid Sharla won't be going with you. She opted for the cash payoff instead. But you won't be lonely. I'll be waiting for you in your cabin.
Whatever.
You come with me, doofus.
That's Laffer.
Here's your limo, Lasser. Enjoy the ride.
Wow! What a cherry 73 Pacer!
Finally, your luck has changed, Larry. 2 weeks at an exclusive health spa filled with gorgeous women.
La Costa Lata, here I come!
Und da sind wir jetzt nun endlich im Spiel angekommen. Hallo und herzlich willkommen, der NRW Boy 18 hier. Und ich begrüße euch zum neuen Larry Let's Play. Larry 6, reiß auf oder schieb ab. Es tut mir leid, ich habe gestern tatsächlich erst Larry 5 beendet. Und heute geht es jetzt direkt schon weiter mit Larry 6. Es tut mir leid, ich bin einfach zu neugierig. Und wie wir hier schon festgestellt haben, ist es ein Meilensprung zwischen Teil 5 und Teil 6. Wir haben hier Sprachausgabe, das Ganze ist schon recht moderner geworden. Wir haben eigentlich das Jahr 1993, da ist das Spiel für MS-DOS erschienen. Ein Jahr später wurde dann eine überarbeitete und erweiterte Version als CD-ROM, praktisch für Windows, dann veröffentlicht und dann hatte man halt hier diesen großen Luxus mit Sprachausgabe, mit diesen kleinen Bildchen hier unten und. Bei mir gibt's das Spiel natürlich auf Deutsch, allerdings nur unten die Untertitel. Die Sprachausgabe ist auf Englisch, denn die wurde nie für Deutsch leider lokalisiert. Also, nach diesem, glaube ich, längstem Intro, was ich jemals in meiner Let's Play-Karriere gehabt habe, mit fast 13 Minuten, sind wir nun hier im La Costa Lotta angekommen. 2 Wochen Urlaub stehen uns bevor. Ich bin gespannt, was uns erwartet. Das ist für mich natürlich ein Blind Run. Die Kronleuchter hier oben sehen aus wie Augen. Was macht Larry jetzt? Und gut, wir unterhalten uns hier mal mit der Empfangsdame, würde ich sagen. Larry, wo willst du hin?
The woman behind the front desk is a real knockout. Although you can only see down to her waist, what you see is what you like.
Oh, Hallöchen. Holla, die Waldfee, hier geht's aber direkt los. Wollen wir doch mal gucken.
You seem to be unable to look anywhere else.
Allerdings, es ist sehr dominant.
Look at that voluptuous mouth. Right now there's nothing in the world you wouldn't give to feel the delicate softness of lips like those pressed urgently against your own.
Own what?
You gaze deeply into Gammy's piercing green eyes as you flutter your own lids as if to say, Baby, your man has arrived.
Also der Erzähler...
Stop staring at me with that creepy look. I can see the whites of your eyes.
Also der Erzähler ist schon mal ganz gut, der gefällt mir.
Thick waves of flaxen hair caress her cheeks and cascade down her shoulders, leading your eyes to... Gammy's slender, slightly tanned arms look good enough to nibble on. In fact, that may be the only thing this lady is missing. Teeth marks. Okay. From her wild mane of sandy hair to her bodacious physical attributes, Gammy Boisulet is a frighteningly beautiful girl who will try anything once, just for kicks.
I hope.
Oh, Larry, du hast dich nicht verändert.
From her wild mane.
I hope I.
Jetzt schon?
Please, sir. Don't you have any other form of identification?
Woher soll ich das wissen? Okay, schauen wir uns hier das oben mal an. Also die Oberfläche ist ähnlich wie bei Larry 5. Was ist das hier? Ist das unser Inventar? Ich weiß es nicht.
Of course, her firm but pendulous breasts are enough to drive any man insane with lust. But try to restrain yourself.
Okay. Ah, das mit dem Weiterklicken klappt ja auch wesentlich besser.
Good day, miss. My name is Larry. Larry Laffer. I'm here as a guest of Stallions, that famous television show.
How do you do, sir? I'm Gammy Boisulet, head of human services and customer relations here at La Costa Lotta. My job is to make sure your visit here is everything your heart desires. And less.
Okay.
I suppose we could begin by checking into my room. I do have a room, don't I?
Oh, but of course, Mr. Laffer. Stallions has taken care of everything for you.
Oh, weh.
Here's your key. You're in room 201, one of our finest suites, right at the top of those stairs, conveniently located near the ice machine, elevator, and kitchen exhaust fans.
Goodness.
I'm sure you'll find it well worth the price you paid.
Ich habe gerade 2 Punkte bekommen und ja, es ist das Inventar.
Say, baby. What time do you, get off?
Usually right after I get in bed. what was the question again?
Ja, ja. Also das Spiel geht ja mal richtig heftig voran.
How about we get together later? What do you say?
Oh, no thank you, Mr. Laffer. My life consists of work and exercise. I really don't have time for romance.
Okay.
Just work and exercise, huh? What a waste.
Hey, no cracks about my waist, okay? I can't help it. God knows I've tried to reduce. In fact, that's why I came here to La Costa Lada in the first place, to fulfill my dream.
You have a dream?
Yes, I do.
Would you like to talk about it?
Yes, I would. My dream was to work here long enough to afford treatment at La Costa Lada's exclusive cellulite drainage salon. Women came here from around the world to be treated by Dr. Swinebutt, but he was so expensive. I could never afford a complete makeover.
Dr. Schweinebacke. Ist klar, Dr. Schweinebacke.
Dr. Swinehart, did you say? Who's he?
The genius who created La Costa Lada's cellulite drainage salon's marvelous machine. One suck and you were better than new.
Oh ja, das wäre schön.
That's what I always say.
But alas, shortly after I arrived here, Dr. Swinebutt was sued for malpractice and his cellulite drainage salon shut down. Since then, his magnificent machine has fallen into disrepair. Oh, how I long for those halcyon days.
Okay, also muss ich jetzt meinen Doktortitel machen, mich hier als Doktor einschreiben lassen, den Salon wieder aufmachen und Sie als Patientin nehmen? Sehe ich das richtig?
Say again, baby. I've got an idea. What if I, your friend Larry Laffer, could repair this little machine of yours? You know, fix it up, make it right. Wouldn't that make me your friend for life? Or at least one night.
Oh, Larry. If you could do that, I'd be the happiest woman on Earth. And I bet I could make you the happiest man on Earth.
Oh ja. Ich habe schon wieder Punkte gekriegt, wie geil. Also was mich jetzt gerade auch ein bisschen schockiert, unabhängig von dem doch sehr, naja, aus der Luft gegriffenen Intro, wenn man so an das Ende von Larry 5 denkt, finde ich es schade, dass wir hier nirgendwo Passionate Patty haben, sondern dass Larry hier gleich sich an die nächste ranmacht. Also das finde ich echt schon ein bisschen schade.
I'll do my best to fix that machine for you, Gammy. You can count on me. At least somewhat.
Let me know as soon as you get my Wonder Machine repaired, Dr. Fix-It. Have I mentioned I've been celibate for years?
Hoppla.
Yeah, me too. I'll do my best to fix that machine.
Let me know as soon as you get my one.
Yeah.
Okay, ja, dann würde ich sagen, sind wir hier fertig. Ende. Dann schauen wir uns mal um.
Welcome to the front lobby of La Costa Lata. It's plush and heavily carpeted, yet with an underlying cheapness and shoddiness that makes it unconvincingly decadent.
Ach, wie freue ich mich auf diese.
Speaking of which, where's your toupee?
Auf diese ganzen Kommentare im Spiel.
This room feels so lobbyish. You could rap on the counter, but what good would that do? The receptionist is right in front of you. You could. This counter is where the hotel receives strangers as guests, hence the name reception. La Costa Lata allows its preferred customers the convenience of this quickie checkout deposit box. Those lucky customers simply deposit their room keys. It's all on the honor system. You, of course, are ineligible for this program.
Natürlich.
Sticking your hand down into the box filled with room keys, you rattle them all around and have a great little time.
Herrlich.
This door is locked and will stay that way forever.
Schade. Was mit dem Mülleimer?
A quaint old ashtray sits beside the reception counter, reminding customers of those halcyon days before smoking was illegal.
Der Typ macht mich fertig hier.
Wait for me!
Was?
Hang on.
Was? Hey, das war gar nicht... was? Der fährt uns durchs Hotel? Wie geil ist das denn?
We have reached the end of the line. Please watch your step getting off the tram.
Was?
And thank you for riding Art's tram line.
Arztram, das ist eine Toilette auf Rädern.
Ah, please step out of the way. I need to turn my tram around.
Was? Ist das?
Sorry, this is the end of the line for me. But if you'd like to go to the other end of the hotel, wait for me to turn this baby around.
Okay.
You can.
Ja, dann dreh mal.
Wait for me.
Okay, schauen wir uns die andere Ecke des Hotels an.
Hang on.
Das ist das so geil. Herrlich, es gefällt mir so sehr. Er ist sogar angeschnallt auf dem Klositz. Oh, herrlich. Oh, das ist ein Pool. Oh Gott, so ein großes Areal. Ja, Endstation. Oh nee, wir. Was?
We have reached the end of the line. Please watch your step getting off the tram.
Oh, the tram.
And thank you for riding Art's tram line.
Art. Okay.
Please step out of the way. I need to turn my tram around.
Ja, Freunde, dann stellen wir uns hier mal ins Grüne und verabschieden uns von Art des Hauses. Oh, direkt wieder angeschnallt und dann hoffe ich, euch gefällt dieser Auftakt des neuen Larry Let's Plays und wir sehen uns dann alle in der nächsten Folge wieder, wenn wir dann weiter das Hotel hier erkunden. Wir haben immerhin schon 7 Punkte. Mir gefällt super, ich hoffe euch auch. Bis zum nächsten Mal. NRW bei 18. Adieu.